stoned with the sacred order of the tomatoes from the city of Windsor. Somewhere in this room was kind enough to stab my chest with a pin. I will wear it proudly for at least the remainder of the evening. The second thing is I do travel a lot. I don't end up coming to Canada that often, unfortunately. But I've been back to Canada now 3 times in the last 48 hours. And I just wanted to share the last crossing of the border, which has always been an interesting experience for me. Going back into Canada, I came to the tunnel tonight. And the guy in the booth looks inside the car and says, "So," he says, "you're going to be the big speaker in Windsor tonight." And I'm sitting there, I said, "Yep." And he says, "I had a whole lot of people that came by here that were wondering whether you'd be wearing the sweater." This is the last day of my winter outfit. Tomorrow we're going to the t-shirt is doing perfect. And he says, he looks at me and says, "You know what you have to do?" He says, "You have to get dressed up in a bocce ball outfit. Sandals, shorts, and a white t-shirt." And you can tell I haven't lived in this country for a long time. I didn't know what a white beard was. Since I'm a lawyer, I started reaching for the criminal code. But, he challenged me to wear it at a press conference. And I think there's a limit to what I'll do, but anyway, thank you, Minister, for that little introduction, and moreover, for the trust and support that you personally and the government of Ontario has demonstrated towards our company. Good evening to you all. It is a pleasure to be here tonight. The last 7 days have been momentous for both Fiat and for Chrysler Group, days that are not easily forgotten. 1 week ago, exactly today, Chrysler paid off its Canadian and the American government loans in full, thus regaining its independence and its accountability to the public capital market. All of this coupled with Fiat's acquisition of 16% of Chrysler for $1.3 billion and the exercise of its call option on the U.S. treasury position would give effective and legal control over the company to Fiat, thus allowing us to accelerate the industrial integration that was started some 2 years ago. Now, as Minister Cupertino mentioned, I spent the last 2 days here in Canada meeting with government officials, both federal and provincial and Chrysler employees, personally thank them and acknowledge their tremendous efforts and their commitment in helping us rebuild our company. Now, I want to begin tonight by congratulating the Canadian Italian Business and Professional Association for its 50 years of helping Italian Canadians, for contributing to the overall welfare of Canadian society and supporting charitable and educational initiatives like tonight's program to benefit the Italian Studies Program at the University of Windsor. When your organization was formed a half a century ago, a large migration of Italians to Canada had been underway for a number of years. And your association helped many of these immigrants make the adjustments to a new land. It was in fact a few years later, when I was 14, that my family moved from Abruzzo to Italy. And we're still debating today with my mother the reasons why we came. But 2 things we gained from the move were the opportunity to reunite my mother with her family here in Canada, and the opportunity for my sister and I to experience a new way of life, unhampered by what my father saw as an overly confining society in Italy, where connections and status counted much more than talent. Now, I have to admit that it wasn't easy. It's never easy starting from scratch in an unknown land with a foreign language, learn to deal with those moments of loneliness that inevitably come along. It's not easy leaving the certainties of the world you know behind for the uncertainties of a new one. a lot of you have had similar experiences, and you'll understand when I say that the journey was not without struggles and without difficulties. But we were all helped by the spirit that pervades in Canada, the spirit of an open, multicultural and cosmopolitan society that will value the individual and merit are the only passports that are required. Now that spirit has enabled so many people from other cultures to establish themselves and integrate successfully in this country. What has been achieved here is proof positive that true exchange between cultures can produce and does produce winners. I now have dual Italian and Canadian citizenship, but in truth my background includes an even larger aggregation of multinational influences. Well, my father was Italian, my mother is from East Kent and of Austro-Hungarian descent. So I spent my adolescence and another half of my professional life here in Canada, including getting my business and education here at the University of Windsor. So returning to the city always connects me to many personal memories, including some rather lengthy attendances at the main house. But in 1994, my career path took me to Europe, first to Paris, and then to Switzerland and Europe until 2004, when I was asked to take the helm of the concern. And then in 2009, my life brought me back to North America, and this time to Detroit, to tackle the challenge of revitalizing Chrysler. Now, looking at my curriculum vitae, some people may conclude that I'm ethnically confused. And maybe they're right, but to me, confusion is what happens when you take all the influences and simply mix them all together by some kind of stew, in which one ingredient cannot be distinguished from the other. Now, Americans ascribe to the notion of their country as being a melting pot, a process which is designed to get immigrants to assimilate into a distinct American way of life, and to largely leave behind times of their countries of origin. American history shows there is much to celebrate about the melting pot. It is a vital part of the strength and of the richness of the United States. But Canada, as we all know, has taken a different approach to diversity. Instead of a melting pot, the ideal is that of a mosaic. And a mosaic, individual pieces are brought together to create a picture or a design. Each piece keeps its identity but contributes to the whole. And so immigrants to Canada are expected to learn and respect some elements of mainstream culture, including its rules while preserving their own cultural heritage. In this view of diversity, encourages you to celebrate the way your culture contributes its unique perspective and strength to the whole, while accepting everyone else's culture. Now the reason why I bring this up is because the paradigm for diversity and this idea of the mosaic are very close to the way in which the alliance between Fiat and Chrysler has been designed and reflects our approach to integration. And this means aligning with the Fiat and Chrysler organizations, but without discarding the strength of these two very different cultures. It will be in fact very foolish to believe that one culture is better than the other. When the Fiat Chrysler alliance first was announced, I heard a number of contrasting views. Some speculated that Fiat was trying to reinvent itself on the American model. Others, especially in Italy, started thinking themselves as the saviors of an American company. All these points of view are totally wrong in this picture. The truth is that neither Fiat nor Chrysler could have or would have fared well without the other. This alliance gives Fiat the critical mass which is necessary to compete on a global scale. The partnership is enabling both companies to make the leap of portfolio depth that they would not have had the ability to do by themselves. So the truth of the matter is that the savior and the saved live on both sides of the ocean. Fiat and Chrysler have both proud heritages and distinct identities that will continue to be reflected in the products that we deliver. The differences between Fiat and Chrysler are, in fact, the strength of the partnership. The Fiat 500 is an example of the approach that I'm talking about, the work that we've done together to adapt the car to the very different in North American market, highlights the way in which we're building and managing this relationship. There was intense and close working side by side between the teams in Italy and in Auburn Hills to preserve the Italian essence of the car and at the same time to adapt it to the needs and the habits of Canadian and American customers. The teams went from every detail of the car to enhance what was an outstanding package to change. And the DF500's world-class driving dynamics were tailored for North American driving conditions. And the version that you see on Canadian and American roads is agile, and as fun to drive as its European counterpart, while at the same time providing a cabin experience that is quieter and more comfortable. The people that drive it took on the DF challenge with passion and with vigor. If I told anybody that we would be launching a car in North America, within 23 months after the PF formed this partnership with Chrysler, nobody would believe it. But a car is being produced as we speak and is being built with outstanding quality, which is typical of what we're now doing at Chrysler. And I'm incredibly proud of the fact that Chrysler was able to accept the challenge and move on it definitely. The 500 is a great embodiment of a set of values that fits within the PF brand, in which we intend to make a significant part of the Canadian and American automotive landscape. Now, the 500 only marks the return of Fiat to the North American market after a long distance of 28 years. But it also embodies a new vision of technology's role in the achievement of sustainable mobility. With its low fuel consumption and its low carbon dioxide emissions, is an ambassador of a genuine concern for the environment and an approach to ecological responsibility, which time is finally coming. Now, this attachment to efficient mobility in Italian style is something that is now part again of the cultural fabric of Fiat, something valuable and relevant in today's environment that we intend to develop internationally. The Fiat 500 and sister version of the 500 Cabrio, which was unveiled just last month, the New York Auto Show represents just the beginning of a series of vehicles that will reestablish the Kia brand in the market. The best way to explain what the car is about is to show you a video. We played it at the Los Angeles Auto Show last November to present not only the car but also our values, our passion for autos, our attention to detail, and underneath it all, our approach to life. It embodies the dream on which Fiat was founded back in 1899, the very simple idea of providing freedom and mobility to one and all, of expressing what it really means in Italian, and to appreciate all those moments that make life worth celebrating.
Thank you.
not yet established a consumer response has been quite strong. When Chrysler Canada offered the TF 500 pre-manufacturing models to the public last November 23rd, all 500 units were seen potential sold out in just 12 hours. Now, Reed Bigland, the president and CEO of Chrysler Canada, apparently has a large fan club here, remarked that it were something like Stanley Cup Final Six. And I think this reflected both a clear appreciation for the car and was also evidence of the special relationship between our company and this country. Chrysler has a long-standing relationship with Canada and has incredibly deep roots within this community. Chrysler Canada was founded here in 1925 at the Windsor Assembly Plant, is our oldest manufacturing facility dating back to 1928. It is also the only remaining auto assembly plant in the city. Altogether, Chrysler employs some 9,000 people in Canada. The three production sites that we have here, the assembly plant in Brampton, and the Etobicoke casting facility, in addition to the Windsor assembly plant, form a key part of the group's overall manufacturing capability. In fact, Chrysler is the number two auto manufacturer in Canada, and our plants in this country account for 30% of Chrysler's worldwide production. In 2010 alone, production in our two Canadian assembly plants increased 51% over 2009, and these two plants today produce some of our most popular models, including the company's flagship car, the long Chrysler 300, in our segment leading minivan. Our sales in this country have increased for 17 consecutive months, and the Dodge Caravan, the Dodge Journey, and the Ram Truck all ranked in the top 10 best-selling vehicles in Canada. In Windsor, we also manage the Automotive Research and Development Center created in partnership with the University of Windsor, which has established itself as a center of excellence in design and virtual reality and simulation of production processes. But the relationship between Chrysler and Canada goes beyond numbers and percentages. We have grown up together, we have shared successes at some incredibly difficult moments, downturns in the economic cycle as well as times of prosperity. Our cultures, our histories, and our futures are totally intertwined. And for all of us at Chrysler, it is a privilege to be part of Canada's identity, and we will continue to play our part to contribute to this country's industrial and social development. In 2009, when Chrysler's very survival was in doubt, the governments of Canada and the province of Ontario, as well as the United States, showed support for us by extending loans at a time when the financial markets were shut and unavailable to most businesses looking for capital. Our efforts were further encumbered by our somewhat checkered history. And yet, someone believed in us. The Canadian and the United States governments extended us loans that gave us a second chance, enabling us to begin the important work that needed to be done. Every single day, for the last 2 years, we have been conscious of the moral responsibility we have to all those individuals and the organizations, and we have made every effort to demonstrate that their sacrifice and their investment was worthwhile. There was a momentous occasion last Tuesday when we announced that significantly in advance of the initial plan, we were paying back with interest every penny that had been loaned and fulfilled our promise. Now, we're still very grateful. We're still very grateful to those who have made sacrifices on our behalf. Not only gave Chrysler the possibility to demonstrate its full potential, but they also represented an act of faith in our partnership and the ability of Fiat and Chrysler to create something better and long-lasting. The Chrysler-Fiat alliance was undisputedly a response to the pressures of the economic downturn that engulfed the auto sector. It forced us to face reality. The American author Arthur Goldman wrote that adversity is like a strong wind that tears away from us all but the things that cannot be torn, so that afterwards we see ourselves as we really are, and not merely as we might like to be. And so the crisis rubbed our noses in the irrefutable reality that no part of the system could afford to indulge in wasteful practices, and the success in the new year required selectivity, rigor, and austerity. And so our partnership was born with this goal to prove that we have learned from experience and that we were capable of building a dynamic future-looking enterprise, one that creates value instead of destroying it. Now, there can be no doubt that the determination and the courage that were shown by Canadian and U.S. governments were unique events. An initiative whose initial objective was to save hundreds of thousands of jobs turned into an opportunity to launch a new Green Deal through which a profound impact can be made on consumer habits, giving support to the auto industry's efforts to reduce emission levels and fuel consumption. This was a structural shift, with government, companies, trade unions, and financial institutions working side by side to go beyond just saving an industry. It represented a true rethinking of the system from an ecological standpoint. In our two automotive groups took a courageous and fundamental step towards change when they chose to merge their respective capabilities, strengths, and know-how to make a major transformation in terms of quantity and quality. Our collaboration enables us to ensure access to adequate capital to leverage technical know-how and investment and face competitors now, finally, on an equal footing. Our two groups are perfectly complementary in terms of products, architectures, know-how, and geographic presence. The presence and experience of Fiat in the smaller car segments and the Chrysler group in the medium and larger segments translate into a full offering and the ability to compete across all market segments. And this alliance is leveraging core competencies on both sides with a very clear definition of roles and responsibilities. We're also sharing best practices in areas such as manufacturing. And in fact, Fiat's world-class manufacturing is rapidly spreading through the Chrysler production system with a very clear objective of increasing safety, efficiency, and quality while reducing waste. And Chrysler's comeback story would never be written without an unrelenting dedication to rapidly improving our product portfolio. Within the first 19 months of beginning operations as a new entity, we brought out 16 all-new or substantially improved vehicles. And this included two new nameplates and 75% of the portfolio carried over from 2009. The efforts and the commitment that we made have all allowed us to again look at growth in all markets and to report a net profit for the first quarter of this year. Every one of these goals was a milestone in our determination to restore credibility and confidence in this house. Taken together, they have helped us change the conversation from a not-so-glorious recent past to a very exciting future. Now, nothing of what we accomplished here could have been possible without the extraordinary strength and resilience of the people at Chrysler and their tireless efforts. The commercial that we aired during this year's Super Bowl, and that many of you probably know, says everything about the new Chrysler and its people. A company that has been to hell and back and yet still dares to dream. A group of people free to venture beyond the ordinary and the expected, free from prejudices and the limitations of habit, free to express their creativity and even break the conventions of what a TV commercial should be. Despot is homage to the culture of action for our industrial roots. It speaks about hard work and the results achieved through resilience and tireless efforts. About people that are not resigned to their destiny, but redesign the future for themselves day after day. It is not simply a commercial, it is the embodiment of our spirit. It portrays our company and its aspirations. It shows our passion for cars and our desire to create the best. And in the end, it expresses the vision that we're making come to pass.
I got a question. about luxury. What does a town that's been to hell and back know about the finer things in life? Well, I'll tell you, more than most. You see, it's the hottest fires that make the heart steel. That hard work and conviction, and the know-how that runs generations deep in every last one of us. That's who we are. That's our story. Now, it's probably not the one you've been reading in papers, the one being written by folks who've never even been here, don't know what we're capable of. Because when it comes to luxury, it's as much about where it's from as who it's for. Now, we're from America, but this isn't New York City. We're the Windy City. We're Sin City. And we're certainly no one's Emerald City.
Industrial neglect, the removal of useful activities is ultimately consenting to these things is a denial of our right to live and to our obligation to protect the welfare of our people. But our work is by no means finished. As Winston Churchill said after the British won an important victory in World War II, now this is not the end, it's not even the beginning of the end, but it is perhaps the end of the beginning. The repayment of government loans closes an important chapter in our history, but working together, Chrysler and CF still have a great deal left to accomplish before regaining their rightful place in the automotive landscape. Our alliance is moving forward rapidly, and we're doing everything possible to accelerate the pace and bring about in the shortest possible time the birth of a single group, bringing even greater stability and strength to the relationship in the interest of both partners. An organization capable of fully leveraging each partner's international capabilities and efficient and a competitive global automaker possessing advanced technological know-how and the determination to establish itself as a leader in the sector. And above all, a group that offers its employees a more certain future in a challenging environment where cultural exchange and integration together with a competitive spirit provide the ideal conditions for their professional and their personal growth. You might well ask, how will the integration of two distinctive companies continue to go forward, and what will be the mosaic that this partnership will take in the future? What I can tell you is that we need to maintain a healthy measure of humility. We want to achieve an integration which will add value to both companies. The fruits of our alliance go far beyond simply the business opportunity to create. Something much more profound is taking place. We at Chrysler are undertaking a cultural integration which is based on mutual respect. Instead of giving up something, each is being enriched by learning from the other. Today, we have an extraordinary group of people working together, listening, exchanging ideas, and expanding their horizons. It is not a casual encounter between passing strangers or curious tourists. We're working and growing together as fellow citizens and as friends. And working together, we will chart a destiny that never forgets its roots, but boldly welcomes the challenges and the opportunities to express our identities in new ways. This is the true strength and, I believe, the most precious part of our partnership, whose value lies in the incredible human wealth which is being created for our people and for our countries. Thank you all.